Well, good morning, everybody, and welcome to this edition of Tech Savvy. Today, we're looking at the provision of Black Friday and what that means in terms of buying your tech and making it available to people. So we're going to be looking at that. And, you know, certainly one of the things that you need to bear in mind is that technology like we encountered today is very, very easy to use, and you may wish to upgrade or change or buy something new. So do by all means consider what you're doing today. And what I wanted to do was just give you some helpful guidance about how to buy tech, because certainly it can be incredibly confusing with so many products online, with so many deals being offered. What's the key points to look out for? What do you need to bear in mind? So do please comment below if you want to ask a question or you'd like to discuss something further with us. Certainly be happy to take those on board. And I'm running a stream right now so that I can see any comments. So I'll just mute myself on the device that I'm looking at.
I'm running a stream right now.
So give me a second while I just try and take the sound out, because that's a bit distracting, isn't it? Thank you. So I'll share this now with people, and they will be able to sort of look at this and take the comments that are coming through. So I'm going to share my screen. I have a little presentation available. So let's have a look at that. And this will give us a clue as to what kind of things would really help us and enable you to get the best out of your Black Friday or purchases for Christmas. So here we go. So this is what I call the beginner's guide to technology and to buying tech. And you will see that I've got some subtitles. So if you're hard of hearing or you need to understand what I'm saying, you will certainly find this is very useful at the bottom of the screen here. So what are the first things you need to consider when you're buying tech? Well, I think the primary reason is, what's your reason for buying this piece of technology? Is it to replace an item? Is it to provide a new item that you don't know a lot about? Certainly, what you need it for is important, and you need to be able to cherry pick the item to suit your need. Also, the second point is, what's your budget? How much are you prepared to spend? And I strongly advise that you keep that in mind when you are buying a product, that you maintain your budget limit and don't get tempted to overspend. And are you replacing or purchasing new? When you're replacing, you're obviously going to do either like for like or better than like. In other words, a different kind of purchase. And certainly when I was going through this, I compared different suppliers and different places to find those particular items to see if the deal was bona fide. So with so many options around, how do you choose? Well, certainly some of the factors that might be involved is you know, your reason for buying, for certainly, and for what that happens to be, whether it's a smart speaker, which is going to enable you to access your music or a music, or just be able to ask simple questions and get answers, or whether it's more like a laptop or a different kind of tablet. Bear in mind that certainly for Android devices, the operating system is pretty static. The device you buy is basically a device that will run apps for a certain amount of time until the updating of that Android system stops, and then you literally cannot buy any new apps. Now, this wouldn't happen for more than several years, but that's an example of how built-in obsolescence may determine your price. Can you trade in your old device? This is particularly applicable for products where where companies are offering you a trade-in for your old device. I have to say that it usually will require your device to be in good working order. Anything less, and it's unlikely to be bought or traded in for your new products. And then, of course, with Black Friday, there are offers and deals to consider. And those kind of deals can be very good. You're liable to save, certainly on tech devices, a range of prices. It won't be spectacular this year. And certainly some of the prices I've been looking at is 50 to 70, 80 pounds. Also, you can consider whether the gift item that the company is offering actually has benefit, or, you know, kind of like an additional gift card that you can spend. But if the price is lower at another place, you may wish to take that option because it's simpler and easier to manage. So it really does pay to shop around at this time if you're considering a purchase. And of course, each person's circumstances are different. So that is why I'm talking very generally and not specific, because certainly you are able to buy something based on what you prefer. So we're going to talk a little bit about your personal preferences and what you think is important. And this involves some buying tips. Please ignore any of this if it's not applicable to you. But some of the buying tips I tend to use, particularly with technologies, don't always buy the cheapest. Sometimes the cheapest is a sell-off of old technology, which you're buying obsolescence. Sometimes you're actually getting a bargain. So don't discount it, that the cheap is not a bargain. It could be, but it's more likely to be a trade-in of some particular feature. For instance, you could be buying in something that could be all singing and all dancing, very expensive. But you are a low user. That means you are somebody who just wants to use emails and a browser. You don't need a state-of-the-art gaming machine that has a super fast speed. What you require is a basic model that will run the internet and will provide you with email contacts. And that doesn't require a lot of computing power. What does require power is video, which is basically you operating and editing video, running video, and large amounts of photographs, but not exclusively that, or running many applications at the same time. Most applications are very what I would call lean and mean. That means they don't take up much space. But things that do are usually video, TV, online streaming. So if any of that applies to you, then certainly go for a better RAM. And my tip about buying on any online or anywhere else is go beyond the label. Check, particularly if you are running multiple applications and doing a lot of jobs, check what the RAM is, because you need the largest RAM. That's the random access memory that enables you to buy the best machine that suits your purposes. And also the processing speed. A lot of the sales have hard disks and good RAM, and then you look at the speed, and it could be as low as 1.6. You really should be looking for things that run a higher speed, but then it gets increasingly complicated with a different processor, AMD or Intel, and whether it's an i5 or i7. To be honest with you, there's very little difference between those two operating systems. But the thing that's liable to cost you more on your machine is the speed of processor, the hard disk, and the RAM. So you need to work out what works for you, particularly on a computer. The same applies for iPads or other mobile devices where you cannot extend the memory. Literally, what you buy is what you get, and therefore you need to actually buy what's appropriate. If you're a heavy user, you might want to buy something that's more midline of the product range. And with so many different options available to you, it can be extremely confusing to find the right option. And so it's worth doing your homework and investigating what's out there and what's around. And finally, based on what you've just heard, based on what you want the tech to do and what you need and what you like, know and feel confident that you've done the best you could and made the best decision at the time. That's important for you to realize that you can't agonize over this endlessly. It is confusing. It is complicated. But at the end of the day, you've chosen something that meets your need, something you like, and something that you want. So that's the end decision. All I've tried to do is sort of make a pathway through there. So thanks for watching. There will be a watch party after this, and we will be playing this onto YouTube as well. I'll bring you back to my screen. Thank you for watching. Tech Savvy is every Friday, and we generally look at something topical or something that has a great deal of use to people. And certainly I want you to feel confident that what you're doing is the best you can do. So whether you're buying anything from headphones to TVs to cameras to computers, laptops, tablets, feel confident that if you have the spec that you go in with that you are looking for, whether it's we want ultra HD or on a TV to a semi-professional full-frame camera, then know that the more expensive items are going to be those kind of tools. But if you're just looking for something that's basic and not too flashy, then you will certainly find something out there, particularly today, that meets your needs. So good shopping, good buying, and look forward to seeing you again next week. Thank you. Bye.